The revolution will not be tweeted. That's how it was looking in the first hour of the attempted coup in Turkey Friday night. Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube all slowing to a crawl. Twitter's global public policy team tweeting, "We have no reason to think we've been fully blocked in Turkey, but we suspect there is an intentional slowing of our traffic in country." Throttling the internet instead of outright blocking it has become the government's preferred method of manipulating social media, according to experts. But just 1 hour after connectivity was at a virtual standstill, social media came roaring back to life in Turkey. The country's president turned to Apple's FaceTime to communicate with the country. Apparently unable to access TV studios, sister network CNN Turk had to interview Erdogan holding up an iPhone using the video chat feature just after midnight local time. It wasn't clear where the president was speaking from. With the connection back, Turkish citizens and journalists turned to live streaming via Twitter's Periscope and Facebook Live to show the world in real time dramatic video of the military uprising. Even capturing low-flying jets zooming over the capital city of Ankara. Turkey is the second most active country on Periscope in the world. Turks moved quickly to get their photos and messages out on social media, not knowing when the next digital blackout might come. The Turkish government has one of the most fraught relationships with social media worldwide. YouTube was blocked more than 2 years there, beginning in 2008. Social media was slowed down in the hours after the recent Istanbul airport attacks, as well as multiple times just before the country's held elections. Now Erdogan is taking to social media himself, tweeting out, "We have put our heads at risk for the sake of this noble cause. This attempted coup will be repelled with God's permission." One of the top trending hashtags in the country Saturday translates to, "I want the death penalty." The hashtag spreading after Turkey's prime minister mentioning that there's no death penalty in the Turkish legal system, but making clear parliament will now discuss what measures should be taken to prevent another coup in the night. Samuel Burke, CNN, London. Democracy bayramımız.